وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه. أحبتي في الله، أيها الآباء الكرام وأمهات الفضليات، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
I think the response I heard should be better than that. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام means peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call us Muslimin, the word derived from peace. And Allah called himself As-Salam, the source of peace. And Allah called Al-Jannah, he said, Udkhuluha, yani he called it Darus Salam, the home of peace. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the angel will be welcoming all of us bi-idhnillahi ta'ala into Al-Jannah. And they will be saying, Salamun alaykum tibtum fadkhuluha khalidin. Salamun alaykum.
Peace.
That's good. It means may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon you. My dear brothers, fathers, mothers, and sisters in the deen, our topic, as we started earlier on, is sihr. Musa alayhi salam, when he was born, Fir'aun la'natullahi alayhi, he was killing all, he ordered for all the boys, newly baby born, to be slaughtered. Why? He was scared that someone will come and take him out of his position. Someone will humiliate him or be the cause for his humiliation. And with this, what happened? Musa alayhi salam, when the mother gave birth to this humble, blessed prophet by Allah, he's been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ, if you are afraid, you are scared that Fir'aun will come and destroy this child, what do you do? فَأَلْقِي فِي الْيَمِ, throw the baby into the
water.
That's good. Into the river. Allah said, وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي. I want you to follow the trend. Why did I choose Musa? Yeah? He said, وَلَا تَخَافِي وَلَا تَحْزَنِي. Don't be scared. Don't be sad at all. What you do? Inna radduhu ilayk. Allah said, I shall, and certainly I will return him back to you. Subhanallah. Inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir. Allah has the power to do everything the way and how he wanted. Allah says in the Quran, وَمَن يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Anyone who puts his or her trust in Allah, Allah is sufficient for you. Wallahi, Allah is sufficient for you. Whatever situation you are, whatever difficulties or problems you are going through, if you put that trust in Allah, Allah will redeem you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the fitna of this dunya and the hereafter. Now with this, when Musa alayhi salam was put into that basket or whatever you may call it and thrown into the river. Now the mother was scared, was afraid that this child will go to who? Or this child will be killed by who? Not by who? By Fir'aun, right? Then Allah said, if you are scared, if you are afraid that Fir'aun will come and destroy or kill this child, what do? You put this child into what? The water. Allah said, I will save him from Pharaoh and I shall return him back to you. And all of a sudden, the person, the woman is afraid that this person will come and destroy this child. What did Allah do? Allah made the child went where?
To him.
to the main man, to the man that the woman was afraid of. Thiqa. Trust. That's how we're going to start our session today. Trust. When you put your trust. You know the problem we have here as Muslims? Let me start within this circle and myself. We say, I believe in Allah. But deep down the heart, you don't believe. Allah said in the Quran, a statement in the Quran. There is one statement in the Quran Allah altered. He said, Inna lanansur rusulana. He said, certainly, I shall help. I will definitely help my messengers. Walladina amanu, and those who have faith in me. This is the Quran. Allah said, I shall make them become victorious on earth. لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُلَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. In this world, they shall be victorious in this world first. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ and hereafter. A believer, you become successful in this world and hereafter. May Allah make us be amongst them.
Amen.
And then this child came to the palace of Pharaoh. He was brought there. And what happened? Subhanallah, just brief. When this child ended up at the house, the palace of Pharaoh, and the mother, I mean the wife of Pharaoh, who became a mother to this child, said, don't kill him. Women power, mate. MashaAllah. Women power. No one can calm Fir'aun down. No one can make Fir'aun sit down except what? A woman. Women power, right? We want you to use your power so we have bigger masjid. That's the best. We want you to use your power to have better ummah. And that's why the Rasulullah said, Ad-dunya mata'. This world is beauty, is joy. Wa mata'uha. The only joy, the best joy you could ever, or person can ever earn, in this dunya, al-mar'a as-saliha, a pious wife. Because when you have a pious wife behind you, then you will see your way towards the right path. May Allah grant all of us pious wives and pious husbands. With that, she said, don't kill him. Maybe we can take this child to be our own child. We don't have. And then, however, Allah used that woman, Asiya, by the name, and calmed Pharaoh down. And at the end, Pharaoh said, no problem. While other people's children are being slaughtered, وَهُوَ لَا يَشْعُرُ, he did not know what is underneath his feet. At the time, I don't want to go into details to tell you the positivity and negative things about royalty. Sometimes they feel like being, you know, any one of us here, to live their life like us. Because it's like they're in prison. Wherever they go, they have guards. Wherever they go, they have cameras. They feel like, I'm not enjoying. They want to be like you. But you have Islam. Peace. I'm telling you. If I go to that, that's another topic. Let's leave it. But however, Musa could barely or had they come out from that palace. When he grew up in that house, but listen to this. When this child was taken into the home, the house of Pharaoh. Now the mother, Allah said in the Quran, he said it was just a bit for her to come to them and say, please, is my child, don't kill him. But Allah said, Rabatna ala qalbiha. I made her become steadfast in her deen. Believe in me. And what happened? They brought different women, different mothers to suckle or breastfeed this child. And Musa never, ever suckled from them. He would refuse and cry. You know when a child, the baby is born, like some of us, we cry, right? So, mashallah. But they brought each and every one of them, and then the daughter of that woman, the sister of Pharaoh, I'm sorry, of Musa alayhi salam, said to them, shall I guide you, direct you to a woman? Maybe she can as well try. You never know. And that woman, she was scared for her child to be killed. And she would even, probably she was thinking how she can bring up a child. And today she was invited with honor into the house of Pharaoh. And she gave her breast, excuse me for language, to the child. And the baby started suckling from that child, from that mother. And now today, she's not just there as a mother, real mother of that child, but she's being paid for giving milk to her own child. Allah said, "Inna raduhu ilayk," I shall return him back to you. That's why I said earlier, if we have faith and trust in Allah, you will definitely get way out from your problems. May Allah forgive us. Now Musa grew up in that home, and he became adult. When he came out, one day, he saw Rajulan Yaqtatilan. Two people were fighting. Hadha min shi'ati. This person is from his own tribe. And the other one from another tribe. Musa was very strong. A strong man, not like me, with good muscles. He wasn't like me, mashallah. And he came, he wanted to separate them from fighting. Accidentally, when he separated them like this with force, one of them passed away, died. And no one knew. Why? That's why I used the word royalty. They could hardly, the people barely know them. If any of the prince or whoever comes here, you can hardly know him. If not the newspaper, you wouldn't even know, right? Now, this is what happened. No one knew who did that act. And the penalty at that time, that anyone who killed should be what? Khalas. The law of the land. Now, who did this act is the son or the claimed son or alleged son of who? Good. The boss himself. You get it? Good, let's go. Now, no one knew personally this person who did it. And they keep searching, they are in search of this person who have committed this act. Killed an innocent soul. All of a sudden, Musa of course was scared. He came out another time, just to have a work. When he came out, he saw the same man who was fighting that day is fighting today. Some of the people, that's how they are. Well, like, wherever they go is trouble. Fighting. And Musa said to him, "Innaka laghawiyyun mubin." You are a naughty man. And then he was fighting with another person. Musa alayhi salam came towards to separate them. And the man said to him, the man he was going to help to separate them, the man said, "Aturidu an taqtulani kama qatalta nafsan bil ams." Oh, Musa, you want to kill me like the way you killed that man that day. Now, people heard this. Huh? And then everyone got to know, they knew that Musa was the one who killed that man. And the message reached who? The boss himself. And the boss said, "Indeed, this was the boy I was looking for. This is the boy I was in search for." And then they had a meeting. One of them came out from the meeting and he said, "Inna al-mala'a ya'tamiruna bik liyaqtuluk." The elders, the chief, they have meeting right now to kill you. "Fakhruj," go out. "Inni laka min an-nasihin," I'm just advising you. And eventually Musa alayhi salam, he left Egypt. You following the trend, yeah? He left Egypt. On his way going, he was so tired, hopeless, sat there. And then he had nothing with him towards Madian. And he saw two ladies. They were struggling to fetch water. Yeah? So, you know, water there, firm or swamp or whatever. And Musa alayhi salam went and helped them. And then the daughters, they went to the father. And not knowing that the father was a prophet. And that is Prophet Shu'aib's daughter. You know, Our prophet is sent to the entire world. Another time you have different prophets to different tribes or different cities. So Musa alayhi salam used one of the beautiful dua I love. Rabbi bima anzalta ilayya min khayrin faqir. Said, oh Allah, why did you bring this good to me while I'm a poor man, unable to achieve what I want? And then Shu'aib alayhi salam sent for Musa. And Musa came, yeah, with the permission of Prophet Shu'aib. And he explained to him everything. And he said, you are safe. Where you are now, you are safe. And they had an agreement for him to work for Prophet Shu'aib for 8 years. Please do not offer your daughter to someone said, work for me for 8 years. That was the law at that time. Not now. Right? Don't say, come and work for me for 10 years. Otherwise, I will not give you my daughter. That's contrary against Islam anyway. However, and they had their agreements at that time. And he got married to one of the daughters. First of all, the father wanted to give Musa his reward, so Musa will go. But subhanAllah, one of the daughters fell in love. And how did he, actually did she, indicate or justify her love to the father? He said, yeah, father, he said, please, just establish you. Just, you know, make this man stay here and you pay him monthly. And the father knew, my daughter is enough. That is better. So he proposed on behalf of his daughter. However, Musa alayhi salam, when that happened, he moved. They stayed there, he finished everything, and he left to Egypt again. On his way going to Egypt in the night, winter, the place was very cold. They lost their way going back. And then what did Allah do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed him fire or light by Mount what? Mount Sinai. Right? And when he saw the fire from far, he said, Inni anastu nara. I saw fire. And why did he go to that fire? He said, let me go there, maybe I can get a firewood to make fire so we can warm ourselves. Or maybe there is smoke there, I can get direction to our destination. And when he came, he heard the voice of Allah. Inni ana Allah. The first time he heard the voice of Allah, Allah said, Ya Musa, oh Musa, I am Allah. Take off your shoes. And he took off his shoe. And what happened? Allah asked him one question. He said, وَمَا تِلِكَ بِيَمِينِكَ. What do you have in your right hand? That's one question, right? As a teacher, when I teach, I ask my students, I draw a question. And I said, what is the color of this wall? And if they say to me, it's magnolia, it has some kind of crippled thing, and it bend there, what do you think I will give them? No. Zero. Because I asked them for one thing, they give me 20. I didn't ask you about that. That's true. I'm sorry. My students, they say that, sir, you are greedy. I said, no, don't worry. Just answer my question. However, why did I mention this story? Listen to this. And then he said, Ya Musa, what do you have in your hand, your right hand? And Musa said, here asaya. That's one. He said, it's my stick. That's one, right? Atawakkau alayha. He said, I lean on it. Wa ahushu biha ala ghanami. And I use it to look after what? My animals. And then he said, waliya fiha ma'aribul ukhra. I do with it some other stuff as well. Come on, Allah asks you, what do you have in your? What do you have in your? Then what would you say if you were you? I have? Finish! But why Musa started keep on talking? Why? What do you think? Why? Why did he just keep talking? Why? No, one at a time, please, so we learn. No, not you. No? Anxiety. MashaAllah. What else? Yes, my mother there. Frighting. My mom, I love your smile. Keep smiling. What's your name, mommy? Arowolo. You've got Yusuf Arowolo today, inshallah. Now, beautiful. Yes, let's move on. Why did Musa alayhi salam mention so many things about the stick?
Well, maybe for another person to come. The next question will be, what do you do with it?
I love that. So you answer the questions to come. Okay. However, according to the ulama, they said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's voice is extremely delicious. Musa could not stop to trigger the voice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him to be addressed by Allah. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when people enter Al-Jannah, he said, وَلَدَيَّ مَزِيد, I have more to give you. And the mazid is seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah talking to you with a beautiful voice. Allahu nurun ala nur, light upon light. So he just wanted to listen, hearing the voice of Allah again and again. He could not stop. Right? That was one of the reasons. So he kept talking. And then Allah said, however, throw your stick. And he got all these miracles Allah gave him. And where did Allah ask him to go? To Pharaoh. Now you see why I started the story with Musa? Allah said to him, اذهب إلى فرعون إنه طغى. He said, go to Pharaoh. He has transgressed. He has gone beyond bounds. And what happened? When he came to Pharaoh, and then he said to him, Allah sent me to you. He didn't want to go himself. He asked Allah, he said, Allah, can you support me with my brother? And Allah said, you've got your request. Your request is granted. And now they came to Pharaoh. He had his miracles Allah gave him to throw the stick, and then the stick turned to what? Snake. And then the other miracle Allah gave him is to take his hand and put it under his bosom, and when he brings it out, is what? Beautiful. I love it. You are all shuyukh and sheikhs. That's beautiful today. That makes it easier for me. However, what did Musa, Pharaoh said to Musa? Pharaoh said to Musa alayhi salam, he said, inna hadha, he said this, lasihir, this is sorcery. This is black magic. Whether it's black, whether it's right, whether it's red, this is magic. He said, this is sin. He said, so you're not going to defeat me with your magic or your black magic or your sorcery. Danger is coming. And then he said, فَبْعَثْ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ. He said, send to all the cities. I want to get the greatest of all magicians or black magicians or sorcerers. Bring them. And when they brought those powerful ones, they came to Pharaoh, they had an agreement. The agreement is, if you defeat Musa with his magic he brought to you, his sorcery, you will be the closest one to me as chiefs. They said, no problem. There is no honor at that time one could earn better than that honor. And they agreed. What happened? They all gathered. And then they said, throw. They asked Musa first, can you throw your own stick or magic, whatever? And then Allah revealed to Musa, said, no, tell them to throw theirs first. And all of them, they throw theirs. Allah said, تَخَيَّلْ فِي أَعْيُنِهِمْ. It resembled to them that something is powerful. Something is frightening. Allah said, تَخَيَّلْ. It appears to them. But تَخَيُّلْ in Arabic is something that comes in an artificial way. It's not a real thing. They show you behind doors. It's not true. But they make it appear to you like it's true. You see the Quran? You see the language of the Quran? You need to ponder over that. Now, that happened. Allah said, "Khayr ilayhim." People were scared. And even Musa alayhi salam was what? Was scared. What he saw, it was danger. And then Allah said, he used the word in the Quran. He said, "La takhaf." Do not be scared. Don't be afraid. Would you tell someone, don't be afraid if you're not afraid? Say, don't be afraid. He said, wala yuf. He said, innama. What they said is what? Sihr. What they throw to thee is what? Is sihr. Is sorcery. Is black magic. Wala yuflihu sahiru aythu ata. This is what you need to take with you now. That Allah said in the Quran, wherever a sorcerer, a black magician appears and they display their magic to harm you, to hurt you, they will never ever succeed over you. As long as you have who?
Allah.
He said, throw it. And he threw the stick, the staff. And that staff changed. And it destroyed, swallowed everything that appeared from those seer, the sorcery or magic they displayed. And these magicians, they said, they themselves, they knew that, no, this cannot be magic. This is real. All of them be prostrated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe in Allah. And this is when Musa, Pharaoh said, he said, oh, now I know that you plotted. So you've gone to them earlier before I called them. You've gone to them earlier for them to connive with you. So you plotted against me today. And this is when he started to amputate them. Black magic. Sorcery. It's dangerous within the community. And I want you to understand this. The Rasul ﷺ talked about sorcery. He talks about ayun, eyes, evil eyes. You have someone, they don't look at you out of envy or hatred for you to be affected, but out of amazement, they look at you and you get affected. Fine. And you call those black magicians, and I will tell you, I will not tell you how they call the jinn because I don't want you to do it. When I give lectures on that, I will just tell you just tips. Because sometimes when I stand on the member, some other magic as well, I was talking about magic and sihr and the ilaj. And I was so scared, I said, if I mention how they call the jinn, how they use the jinn, maybe, God forbid, one day one or two will get upset or angry, and then they take advantage of it. And they will refer it, they said, Sheikh Yusuf told me, may Allah forgive me from that. That's why I will not tell you how you call them. So you could not do your research. However, these people, how do they get their magic and things they do? First of all, it's from the jinn. That's one. I want you to understand this. Don't see when they do this relation, these kind of things you think is real. No. They use those jinn. And it's a contract that you have to sign with a jinn. Anyone who become a magician and doing this black magic things to affect someone, that person has already signed his Jahannam. One, what do you do for them, or what the person does for them to get the jinn and the jinn adhere to their rules? Excuse me for language. They have to humiliate the Quran. One, they have to write the Quran with either urine, we. Excuse me for language, Akramkumullah, or the menses of a woman. They write the Quran with it. They take the Quran and put it under their shoes. You have to take the Quran to the toilet. And so more. Many more. I'm not going there. And immediately when you do that, when you adhere to their rules, they adhere to your rules. And they can harm you. I tell you the truth. They can inflict disease on someone. There are some genes, the same. They just go and attack the person and cause disease in them. They will just hurt the person by his heart. The person struggle. Trust me, he or she will not die except the time Allah decree for them to die. But they will suffer. There is, and I want us to take this very serious. And some of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use in the Quran, Surah Al-Falaq, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ مِنْ شَرِّ مَا خَلَقَ وَمِنْ شَرِّ Good. I want that word before I go to the Quran, نَفَثَاتِ. Yeah, Allah use a masculine gender, feminine gender. Because most of those who go, most of those who go to black magicians and those people who do this black magic to affect people are women. Nafathat. Some, it's so sad. They go to the black magician and they use the jinn to tell, they tell, I want my husband to love me. They call it Sihrul Adl. The Sihr has different names. And we're not going to, I'm not going to all those details. What's important for us to know is the danger and the existence of that Sihr. And they have the one they said for love, where the man goes sometimes as if he's crazy.